Hey guys, King's Island Fanboy here. Welcome back to another video. Today we're just going over a quick update that King's Island just released about the Beast Retract that we touched on a few weeks ago. So King's Island has officially made a blog post about this retract, going more in depth of which manufacturer is doing the retract and a few other touch-ups they are doing along the ride. So I'm just going to read over this and I'll give my final thoughts at the end of the video after we go over everything that is happening. The world's longest wooden coaster, the Beast at King's Island, is receiving 2,000 feet of track refurbishments this winter. The Gravity Group, which installed 600 feet of its new engineered pre-cut track on the park's Racer roller coaster last winter, is breathing new life into the ride's first drop and through the first tunnel and towards the second drop and 540-degree helix. While King's Island's carpenters are retracking approximately 1,090 feet of track in other sections along the 1,359-foot long course. The first drop will see a change from 45 degrees to 53 degrees. This change isn't being made to add more speed or thrill to the ride, but to actually lower in the tunnel to provide proper parabolic arcs due to reprofiling of the track in that area. This change, along with Gravity Group's vertical track design, will deliver a buttery smooth transition into the tunnel from the second drop. The Beast Helix crossover will see a redesign and installation of new bends. With the redesign, the forces through the structure will be more evenly distributed. The rigidity of each bend will be more consistent and therefore resulting in a smoother ride experience. Let's start off with the first bit of this. Starting with the Gravity Group. I already assumed that Gravity Group would be doing some sort of work on this ride. We saw that with Racer, and Gravity Group has been working with King's Island a lot more closely recently. You know, them being a Cincinnati company, so they're very close to each other, less than an hour apart. They can work very easily together. And then with their new pre-cut track, we did see this installed on Racer, and we did see that they installed a little bit on Kentucky Flyer when they were building it and, you know, prototyping this track. I think this track is really interesting. We haven't seen any of like this prefabricated wooden coaster track since the Intamin prefabs came out that long time ago. We haven't seen anything since. So I'm really interested to see how this works. I mean, we've seen it on Racer. We know it's smooth, it's stayed smooth, and it has great airtime with that. But I'm really interested to see how it works on Beast. I personally, very controversial opinion, I love the roughness of the Beast. I love how it throws you around and beats you up. That's what a Beast does. That's why it is the Beast. So I'm really interested to see how this prefabbed, really smooth track will work on this ride where it's supposed to be, you know, throwing you around. It's supposed to be rough, basically. Then we also have in this with King's Island's carpenters retracking 1,090 feet of this track. So we will see a little bit more improvements throughout then. I did assume that King's Island would be doing track work on this ride. We saw a few problems with that this year. So, just all of that with the new prefab track and Gravity Group. Really interested to see how it's going to ride next season. Let's get on to the second part here, the really interesting part. The change of the drop from 45 degrees to 53 degrees. This is a really interesting change. They say it's to make the drop into the tunnel more smooth with the retract that Gravity Group is doing there. Now, Beast Drop currently doesn't have any airtime to it, and I'm not saying them changing from 45 to 53 will provide an airtime, but I would like to see a little bit of a change there. See, maybe it does give you a little pop of airtime going down that hill. Maybe it's smoother, maybe it's more thrilling, just that 53 degrees, that 8 degrees steeper, seeing how much it really changes the ride experience in that sense. And then the final part here, with the Beast new vents that are being installed on the ride to make it smoother. I think this is a really great change, something, because, you know, track isn't always the reason a ride is rough. Kids, it's the supports, it's the ground that the ride is on. There's a lot of different factors that can make a ride rough. It's not just the track. It's not just the track here is messed up, that's why the ride is rough. No, it's the, you know, as we see here, it's with the bends, the rigidity of the bends, and how far they're spaced and where they are. Where changing these can make it a lot smoother in this sense. So I'm really just to see how that rides. Overall, I'm just really interested to see how this how the beast will ride next season. As I said before, I love the roughness of the beast, so I'm hoping this doesn't drop into my rankings. I love the beast. It is my number two favorite coaster and my favorite coaster at Kings Island. So I'm really interested, again, just to see how this rides. Hopefully it doesn't make it too smooth. I love my rough beast, but I doubt it'll change the night rides. The night rides are what do it for me. But overall, really interested to see what they're doing here. Well, that's all for this video. I want to hear what you guys think of this retrack down below and Gravity Grip's new prefabricated track being used on it. I'd like to hear what you guys think about that all down in the comments below. And before you go, I have a little announcement to make. Yes, I am working on a Christmas video. Some of the filming has delayed that video a little bit till after Christmas. So we're going to have to wait a little bit between that. Hopefully going to get it up between Christmas and New Year's. Making it kind of a Christmas New Year's special. So hopefully get it up around then. If it's not up before then, I'll try to get it as soon as I possibly can. Also, it just might be delayed. But I have not forgot a Christmas video. I'm still working on it. It just got delayed. Sorry about that. Again, I want to hear what you guys think in the comments below about this. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.